Sergeant Thiel, do you happen to know why he was under censure?
I do, sir. His commanding officer discovered that he was running theoreticals on how to fight and defeat Space Marines, sir. Thiel claimed, in his defense, that he had run theoreticals on all other major adversaries, and it was a tactical blind spot not to know how to fight the legions. He said, as I understand it, that the Space Marines of the Imperium were the greatest warriors in the galaxy, and thus had an obligation to understand how to fight and defeat the greatest warriors in the galaxy. Thiel declared that Space Marines were the only opponents left worth any theoretical study. His theoreticals were regarded as treasonous fort, and he was referred to the flagship for censure.
That was his infraction?
Asked Gage.
Looks bloody pitiful from where we're standing, doesn't it?
The doctrines of the Imperium, such as the Codex Astartes, bind humanity's purpose into values fit to carry out the will of the Emperor. For while there are many heretical tomes devised by madmen, one must reflect on the value of insight, whilst being cautious of overstepping into the boundaries of heresy. For today, we shall elucidate a Space Marine whose vindication would aid in the future of not only his Angels organization, but survival. The Sergeant of the Ultramarines Legion, Aeonid Thiel. The Angels of the Legiones Astartes would be crafted by the Emperor of Mankind for a singular purpose. The galaxy's human inhabitants had been scattered and fragmented, with untold civilizations becoming besieged and enthralled by heretics and Xenos alike across the stars. In order to unite humanity, a bloody conquest of the solar system would be the only method to bolster the now burgeoning Imperium of Man. With Holy Terror united, in part due to the deeds of the ill-fated Thunder Warriors, such barbaric killers would need to be culled to make way for a new breed of soldiers. Crafted to purge the galaxy of any whom would threaten the future of humanity, the Astartes would slay the Thunder Warriors of Terror before carving a path through the galaxy. Embodying the greatest traits of humanity's heritage of waging war, each legion would be tailored to end the uprisings and insurgencies of any whom should challenge the Emperor's great vision for his Imperium. No foe would be capable of denying his Angels' indomitable might, and with the closing of the Great Crusade, the Legiones Astartes had proven to be the single most deadly and efficient army to ever conquer the stars. Yet with few enemies to test their blades and bolters against, a theoretical would spark in the mind of a singular Space Marine. The Sergeant of the Ultramarines 13th Chapter, Aeonid Thiel. Aeonid would draft battle scenarios and strategies that would pit the deadliest warriors in the known galaxy to face the Astartes, their own brethren. An idea bordering on treasonous, Aeonid's senior officers would discover his theorems and decry his openly heretical ideas. Defending his position as a tactical necessity and obligation to bolster his legion's knowledge in combat. For there remained no other combatants capable of defeating or challenging the Imperium's mightiest warriors. Thiel's senior officers would demand he face censure and send the disgraced sergeant to face judgment aboard the Ultramarine's flagship, McCragg's Honor. Coating his battle helm red as a mark of censure, Thiel would comply to be judged by the chapter master, Antoli, and his Primarch within the Calth system. Yet with an ironic twist of fate, Thiel's theoreticals would prove to be less heretical than initially perceived, with the fall of the War Master to the thrall of the Ruinous Powers. Horus Lupercal would be corrupted by the malevolent powers of Chaos. Orchestrating the purge of his own loyalist Astartes within his ranks, Horus would devise a strategy to buy his rebellion time to grow in strength and manpower. To this end, Horus would require a distraction to keep the most numerically superior legion at bay, the Ultramarines. Dispatching the 17th Legion, the Word Bearers, the masters of demonology and summoning rituals, would attempt to overwhelm the Ultramarines with a sudden and overwhelming surprise attack. Their treachery unknown to the 13th Legion, the Ultramarines would accept the Word Bearers into their fleet with open arms as fellow battle brothers. With their guards lowered, the Ultramarines' betrayal would be enacted. Under the command of their Primarch, Lorgar Aurelian, the Word Bearers would slaughter the Lords of Ultramar. axe-stabbing their once brethren, the Word Bearers would deal a crippling blow to the 13th Legion with the initial stages of their plot. Jamming the Ultramarines' communications, preparing their fleet's weapon batteries, and beginning their summoning rituals using the Butchered Dead, the Word Bearers would seemingly break the Ultramarines in one fell strike. Yet the 17th Legion had not prepared for the Ultramarines' resolve, ingenuity, and the disgraced sergeant harbored within the McCrag's honor. As the Word Bearers began their plot, Aeonid would wait for judgment within Roboute Guilliman's chambers of the Ultramarines' flagship. Already aware of his likely expulsion and possible execution for his views, Aeonid would see no harm in practicing with Guilliman's personal weaponry housed within his chamber's private armory. The exotic and mastercrafted weapons would be varied and potent examples of his Primarch's countless victories and compliances throughout the galaxy. Yet as Thiel tested the swing of each blade within the collection, he would be interrupted by the invasion of demons within the McCrag's honor. Battling the demons with blade and bolter, Thiel would begin to understand the vulnerabilities and traits of the warp-spawned beings. Finding firearms to be less effective than melee weapons and the searing heat of flame, Thiel would arm himself with a selection of his Primarch's personal weapons. Finding the disorganized and disparate warriors, crew serfs and laborers within proximity to his Primarch's chambers, Thiel would organize the crew of the McCrag's honor into a discordant yet capable company. Arming them with the weapons found within Roboute Guilliman's private armory, Thiel's band of mismatched fighters would battle their way to the ship's command bridge. Arriving at the command bridge in time to prevent the first chapter master of the Ultramarines, Marius Gage, from being slain at the hands of a demon, Thiel's would-be band of warriors would purge the foul machinations of the warp from the bridge. Bringing an apothecary to tend to Gage's wounds, the chapter master and Thiel would converse on the methods they could use to repel the Word Bearer's assault. Aeonid's theoreticals on how to best fight Astartes now proving invaluable, Thiel would surmise that the Word Bearer's greatest weakness would be for the Ultramarines to eschew their otherwise rigid and predictable battle doctrines. Approving of Thiel's assessment, Gage would relay orders to the Ultramarines' resistant forces to scour the McCrag's honor to purge the demonic entities of the ship under the command of Aeonid. Successfully regaining control of the McCrag's honor, Thiel and Gage would reunite with their Primarch, Roboute Guilliman, aboard the flagship. Guilliman would propose an assault of the orbital weapons platforms surrounding Calth, currently occupied by the first captain of the Word Bearers, Cor Pharaon. Thiel would concur, and with 50 Astartes under his command, accompany his Primarch to assault the platforms. With the Ultramarines' command hierarchy shattered by the Word Bearers, Guilliman would order the assault squad commanders to paint their helmets red as a mark of senior rank. With their vox communication still unreliable, Guilliman would require a simple and clear visual cue to denote the senior officers' ranks. Facing Cor Pharaon and his elite Galvorback honor guard, the Ultramarines would valiantly fight the duplicitous servants of Chaos. Yet for their efforts, Cor Pharaon would escape judgment, despite the first captain's heart being ripped from his chest by the hands of Roboute Guilliman. The Word Bearer's fleet would retreat, with half their fleet destroyed, with the Ultramarines' resurgent strength and opposition to their betrayal. Subsequently, Guilliman would muster his fleet to persecute the traitors to the throne and assign Thiel to purge the now ravaged surface of Calth of the remainder of Word Bearers left to die by their own legion. Aiding in the relief effort and underground war of Calth, Aeonid would prove to once again be integral in hunting down and persecuting the traitor Astartes. Yet his deeds and infamy gained from Calth would not go unnoticed, for there would be those among the traitor war effort whom would use his glory to mask their own insurgency. After years of toil, Roboute Guilliman would receive word from Aeonid Thiel on his progress in the reclamation of Calth. Eagerly inviting his unconventional yet trusted son to confer with him, Guilliman would come to value Thiel's eccentric yet honest insight. Accompanied by a squad of Astartes of so-called Orphans of Calth, the armed and armored space marines would gain audience with the Primarch within his personal chamber. Without the protection of his honor guard and sealed within his chambers, Thiel would reveal himself to be an imposter. The real Aeonid Thiel, stationed on the surface of Ajax, was investigating the silence of a once bustling Promethean refinery. For those in audience with Roboute Guilliman were not loyal sons of Ultramar, but servants of the Hydra. Without weapons or armor, Guilliman would battle the Alpha Legion imposters. Injured at point-blank range by the insurgents' bolters, Guilliman would narrowly manage to kill each and every one of the 20th Legion Astartes before collapsing from exertion. As his Primarch lay bleeding within his chambers, Aeonid would discover the Promethean rig of Ajax to be abandoned. Unaware of the plight of his gene father, Thiel would battle through the rig's security measures to find a solitary tech priest of Mars. Explaining that the rig's crew had succumbed to madness and flooded the station, killing the majority of its inhabitants. Set upon by the Alpha Legion, Thiel and his men would face the traitors. The Alpha Legion Astartes, wielding strange sorceries, would overpower Aeonid, yet with his stalwart battle brothers at his side, Thiel would be saved from the Hydra's killing blow. Mortally wounding the 20th Legion insurgent, the Astartes identifying himself as Alpharius would utter the word Nightfane before succumbing to the embrace of death. With evidence of the Alpha Legion's involvement, Thiel would conclude that Ajax had been infiltrated to a greater extent by the 20th. Knowing more spies lurked within the dark corners of Ajax, Thiel would conduct measures to root out the Hydra's insidious influence for the remainder of the Horus Heresy. With the end of the Civil War to preserve the Imperium ended, Aeonid Thiel's reputation would be personally restored by his Primarch. Ascending to the rank of Captain of the Ultramarine 2nd Company, with their reorganization into a Codex-compliant chapter, Aeonid's legacy would be widespread within the 13th. Once a mark of shame and censure, the red-painted helmet marking of the once Legion was now an honor for the Ultramarines chapter to bear. Denoting the rank of sergeant within the chapter, the redemption of Aeonid Thiel would be an enduring legacy and lesson for all Ultramarines to follow. Even though his whereabouts and deeds following the 31st millennium have been lost to history. Though what is known is that Aeonid would stand at the side of his Primarch during his final recorded engagement of the Battle of Vesala. During 121.M31, the Ultramarines under the command of Roboute Guilliman would seek to bring the 3rd Legion, the Emperor's children, to justice. The traitors to the throne had been repelled from Holy Terror, yet the Great Scouring demanded retribution and blood for their treachery. Commanding the Ultramarines chapter and 6 of its successor chapters, Roboute Guilliman would hunt down the Primarch of the Emperor's children, Fulgrim. Fully transformed into a demon prince of Slaanesh, the serpentine creature, once known as the Phoenician, would snare the Ultramarines into a trap. Ambushing the loyalists of the 13th, the outnumbered warriors of Ultramar would assault the 3rd Legion's flagship, Pride of the Emperor. Assembling a desperate boarding strike team of 100 Astartes, Guilliman would teleport onto the bridge of the traitor vessel. Alongside his Primarch, Thiel would witness the confrontation between the two Primarchs. Despite Thiel's protestation, Guilliman would duel the corrupted Fulgrim in single combat within the ship's Heliopolis. Guilliman would be mortally wounded by the chaos-infused Fulgrim and call for the aid of his captains. Alongside First Captain Andros, Thiel would fight to reach his Primarch. Fulgrim would slit Guilliman's throat with his poison-coated blade, and with a desperate struggle, Thiel would manage to retrieve his Primarch and teleport himself and Guilliman away from the skirmish. Aboard the vessel, Gauntlet of Power, Thiel and the surviving members of the Strike Force would retreat from the battle. The remainder of the fleet sacrificing themselves to allow their gene father to escape the clutches of the 3rd Legion. Thiel's actions once more prolonging the survival of the Ultramarines in their darkest hour. A fighting party appears, moving urgently down the corridor. There are several Ultramarines in it, but it is also composed of army troopers and navy personnel, including at least one abhuman stoker. They are armed with the most mismatched and exotic weapons Gage has ever seen outside Guilliman's private arsenal of... They are all from the Primarch's private arsenal.
Move up. Secure the section.
The sergeant yells.
Bravo Curso, scope the next corridor. Flamers to the front. Apothecary Jair, get to the chapter master, right now.
He bends down beside Gage, setting his weapon on the deck where they will be in easy reach. Close up, Gage can see the scratch marks adorning the sergeant's armor.
You're an apothecary?
Gage asks, his voice a husk of its normal baritone.
Just coming, sir.
Your name?
Thiel, sir. Aeonid Thiel. 135th Company.
Marked for censure?
Today started in a different place, sir.
That it did, Thiel. Well said. Who put you in charge?
I put myself in charge. I was awaiting interview on Deck 40 when everything went to pieces. There was no chain of command. I decided I needed to build one.
This has been a tale of the Great Imperium of Man, read by the Remembrancer. Aeonid's rebellious tendencies would nevertheless be tempered with the loyalty and discipline of his legion. His unconventional tactics and uncompromising duty to the Ultramarines, a testament to the ingenuity of the venerated 13th. For while rules, regulations, and structure are the foundations for his Imperium, there are times when such strictures should be broken. Only in deeds does humanity endure, and any deed made against the tide of the ruinous powers is a worthwhile endeavor.